The Pi Point Builder is one of three different ways of creating Pi tags. You can also create them using something called a tag configurator, which we're going to look at later on in Excel. And also we have a utility called PyConfig, which we're not going to teach in this class. We teach in System Manager 2. It's a command prompt based utility. Anyway, the Pi Point Builder is part of Pi System Management Tools. And you'll find that under, as you can see right here, under All Programs, Pi System. And we're going to go into Pi System Management Tools. Go ahead and launch that if you are not already launching it. And what you'll find here is this system management tool has a points section and a point builder. It's within that point builder that we create brand new tags. So I create a brand new tag by clicking on this new option up here. That creates us a new workspace where we can create these tags. Now, when you create a tag, as you might guess, what you do is you set the attributes and you set them one at a time. Yeah, but a lot of you are probably saying, hold on a second, one at a time. That's kind of crazy. I got 50,000 tags to configure. Yeah, that's why we are going to go later on in the class into this Pi System Management Tools option under Add-ins, Pi SMT. There's a whole section here that we're going to go through in great detail later on about creating tags in mass quantities. So this is not the mass quantity, you know, tag editing system. This is just for doing kind of one at a time edits of Pi attributes. If you want to rename a tag, you simply choose rename. And that what that does is it doesn't delete or create new. It simply renames the attribute of the tag, you know, known as its tag name. Now that will preserve all the history that's stored in the tag, but it's going to break a couple of things. It's going to break your Pi performance equations. Our syntax-based or expression-based calculation engine that ships with the Pi server. Also, if you've got Pi ACE, any calculations that make reference to Pi tags that are renamed are going to have to be re-edited. And if you're using Pi Data Link, that's our add into Excel. Of course, you know, within Excel, we reference the names of the tags, so it's going to break those spreadsheets as well. And what it won't break is most of the other applications. So almost all the other applications don't refer to these tags by their names. Instead of using this name, we're simply using their point ID. Each Pi tag has a specific point ID. I think you'll find it here under the system generated attributes. Yeah, here's the point ID right here. So that's normally how we make reference to Pi tags in things like Pi process book. So go ahead and rename a Pi tag if you need to. You are going to have to fix those applications I mentioned. Now, if there is a need to get rid of a tag, you just don't need it anymore, you want to delete it, that's fine. There's an option to go ahead and delete this tag. If I just do a right click here, I can delete the Pi point. Just be aware that you're going to delete all the history that's associated with that Pi point. And because that's such a severe thing, you know, it's something that's got potentially career threatening ramifications. You typically don't want to delete Pi tags that have been gathering data for years and years. Instead, just go into the archiving section and turn scanning off. If you turn scan off, it effectively means the tag is dead in the water. It's not going to get any new data, but it doesn't delete the history of the tag. Now, if you, hopefully you're not watching this video after having deleted this tag. If you did delete the tag, there is an undelete utility, or excuse me, let me correct myself. There is an undelete mechanism or procedure, but it is not pretty. And if you go onto our tech support website, just do a search for this knowledge base article, you'll see we describe there how you restore. It's something that's only going to work if you've got good backups. And in general, of course, we'd rather you not get yourself in that situation. So be careful before you delete any Pi tags. Better to set that scanning off.